Hello, dearest friends of mine. Today, I am going to be doing some lip swatches of the new Natasha Denona I Need a Rose lip collection. I feel like this isn't as exciting as maybe a Natasha Denona eyeshadow palette, but low-key, high-key on my channel, Natasha Denona's lip products, particularly her lipsticks, are amongst my all-time favorite lipstick formula, and I also love her lip liners, so I was really pumped about this collection. I bought the whole collection for $186 on the Natasha Denona website, so that's an option if you want to be loco and get the whole collection, but the collection is also available on Bootylish, on Sephora, and then Natasha Denona, like I said. If you want to get the whole collection, I would suggest Natasha Denona, but if you're just looking to get a couple colors, maybe Sephora is your best bet in terms of just buying them individually. So there are three different colors in this collection. Calla, or is it Kai? I should look this up, but I'm in a rush. I gotta go to the bank. Calla, Peony, and Daphne. And they're all different tones of roses, and they're in three different formulas. The lip liner, the liquid lip, and the lipstick. So the first collection that we are gonna try is going to be Peony. So if you are buying each item individually, the lip pencil is gonna be $22. Lipstick is going to be $25. And the lip gloss will be $26. Very interesting. I thought this was a liquid lipstick for some reason. No, it's a lip gloss. Okay, I prefer that. Anyways, let's take a look at Peony first. The outer packaging of the lip color is going to be different based on whatever lip color you'll use. Like, for example, you'll see Daphne is a little deeper. The lip liners here have an 18-month shelf life. They're made in Italy, and they're vegan and all of that. Ooh, I love how pretty the packaging is on this one. Okay. So I love her lip liner formula. They are super duper creamy. This is an ultra creamy matte lip liner made with long lasting pigment for all day wear. I'm gonna use these all as a set today. And her lip liners, I don't find them to be the longest lasting compared to like Pat McGrath, but I really love the consistency of them, and they are still amongst some of my most used lip liners. Now, here is the lipstick. Let's see. Lipstick has 18-month shelf life, also made in Italy, and love the outer packaging of this. So what's interesting about this lipstick formula is it's a new formula. So this is not her other formula, which I really love. This is a full coverage, gel-based, voluptuous lipstick, which is supposed to define and condition the lips while providing maximum moisture. Lightweight, creamy texture, melts into skin, and keeps lips plump and hydrated over time. So her regular lipstick formula that I'm familiar with, extremely, extremely creamy, like could melt in the car if you live in a hot condition. So yeah, this feels like it's not quite as soft, which is not a bad thing. Her old formula also broke off easily because it was so creamy, so I think it's kind of good that this feels like it's a little bit harder. How pretty is this? I don't know that this was full opacity. I had to do a few swipes, which is fine, but just something to note. And then the lip gloss. I actually am not a big fan of Natasha Denona's lip gloss formula from what I've tried in the past. Sorry, you guys. I did not do my due diligence on this collection. As you can see, I got a lot going on right now. I'm like trying to pack up my entire life. Here's what the box is going to look like. It has an 18-month shelf life, made in Italy. So this is an extra pampering, soft, and conditioning lip shine gloss formula, formulated with an innovative gel system for smooth, easy glide, and long-lasting wear. So here is what the applicator looks like. So I don't know if this is a new formula, but again, I don't really like her lip glosses to begin with, but it's interesting that this talks about that gel formulation that was also talked about in the lipsticks. How pretty of a trio does this look? Okay, we gotta put this on. I'm so excited. I did hydrate my lips a little bit, but my lips are just dry, period. So let's start off the Peony lip liner. I want you to see the glide here. So easy. This is like lighter than my lips though, and I don't know if I like that. I typically like a darker lip liner. The Peony lip liner has a touch more peach in it compared to the lipstick. I don't know if you guys can see that, but in person I'm noticing that. Let's test the opacity of the Peony lipstick now. It has like a vanilla buttercream kind of scent, but nothing overbearing at all. It's just something subtle. Okay, let's do one swipe. Ooh, it feels quite hydrating, honestly. It definitely is different than the original formula, but it still is soft. Not as soft, but I like it. So you don't get as much of a thick layer with this formulation. It definitely feels thinner. And that's with one coat. Let me swipe a couple times. And it does have a sheen. I like it. It has a similar consistency as I would say like the kissing formula from Charlotte Tilbury, if you're familiar. And it has that same kind of finish as well. I like that, and it is pretty. Even though I didn't like that lip liner, this combo turned out very pretty. They're obviously very flattering for one another. And then finally, let's test out this lip gloss, which has some pigment to it. It's not full coverage, does not have a scent, not sticky. It feels a little thick, but it's not sticky. This is a good little trio. Oh, I like how this collection has like a system for each color. It makes it very easy to decide what lip you want to do. So here is Peony. I love Peony. This is such a pretty pink lip. Okay, so I'm into this. We're gonna do Daphne next. So I've pulled out the Daphne system, and Natasha describes this as a mauve pink system. So let's take a look. Here is the lip liner, definitely a little bit deeper. I think this one's gonna be a little bit more my speed. The lipstick. Has a hint of peach. Nothing outrageous, just a little hint. And now let's get to the gloss. I almost wish the gloss had a sweeter scent to it. It just smells very unscented. Like whatever ingredients are used to make the lip gloss is what it smells like. Very pretty. This is a little deeper. I think this one might be more my speed, but let's see. Starting off with the lip liner. Oh yeah. It's a little bit warmer. The glide is just so easy. Love this application. I would say this is my favorite lip liner application-wise, and just how easy it glides. It feels so thin. It's not like, you know how some lip pencils, they're really creamy and glide on nice, but they're thicker. This is a thinner formula, which I love. Okay, let's try Daphne lipstick. Here's one swipe. Gorgeous. This is my kind of everyday rose tone. I like how it's a little bit more mid-toned, so it defines my lips a little bit more. I don't know that I prefer this formula over the OG formula. It's a nice formula, but I just love her OG formula so much. But I definitely see the benefits of this. Okay, let's finish off with a thin layer of the gloss. Don't want to layer on too much product. I love this lip. Love, 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 love it. So for me, if you have like a similar skin tone to me and you are looking for a really flattering neutral rose tone, this is a beautiful everyday nude lip. So Daphne, thumbs up. Final lip color that we have, which is the deeper one, is Calla, which is a rosy brown kind of lip system. So let's see. Here's the lip liner swatch. Not as deep as I was expecting it to be. It's just like a tone or two deeper than Daphne. Yeah, almost, the packaging almost looks a little bit more orange. Here's the lipstick. This is overall a more warm, kind of peachy lip system. I think this is probably gonna go with my eye makeup the best. I'm wearing like a neutral eye from the Urban Decay Wild Greens today. I like it. I think it's a pretty everyday look, so you can certainly get everyday looks with it. That is not what this video is about, but okay, and then here is the lip gloss. This looks like a gorgeous, like nude lip gloss with like rosy undertones. This, let's see how it looks before I say anything. I was gonna say, it doesn't look that rosy, but I think it might translate on the lips. So let's try the lip liner. Totally warmer. This lip liner is a little bit more contoury on me. Okay, I love this lip liner. Absolutely gorgeous. Let's do the lipstick. It's almost like a peachy rose. It's oddly neutral. I love it though with my look. Okay, now lip gloss. So this is giving me more peachy neutral. I really, really love it though. I think it is gorgeous as well. I think for me personally, my favorite is going to be Daphne for like my everyday nude rose shade. They're all three gorgeous though. I honestly don't think you could go wrong. As far as my recommendations, I mean, I would just go ahead and get like a whole system. Not the whole collection, but treat yourself to one of the colors of every category because it's so fun just to have a lip color curated for you that you know is going to look good. One thing I'm gonna watch is the lip gloss wear time. And that is something that I struggled with when it came to the Natasha Denona lip gloss formulas that I've tried in the past. I felt like they disappeared like in 2 minutes on my lips and lost their gloss and shine. So I'm going to update you and let you know how wear time is on these.
Quick update. Oh my goodness. So I ate breakfast and it's like... Does that happen to anybody else? Anyways, so wear time on these aren't spectacular. The lip liner is gonna last the longest, but with the lipstick and the lip gloss being cream, they kind of just come off. I noticed the lip gloss kind of sunk into the lipstick, which lost a little bit of glossiness. Nothing terrible. They're cream lip formulas. Just don't go in thinking these are gonna last all day. You're gonna need to keep them in your purse. Like I said, nothing bad. But they're cream lipstick, so that's what happens.
But overall, I really love this collection. I think it is solid. I know it's just a lip collection, and a lot of us probably don't need lip stuff, but I love how the colors were curated for you. I think all of the formulas are pretty nice. Lip liner formula is on point. Lipstick formula is also really great. I prefer the older OG formula, but this is, I think, something that needed to be done because those lipsticks were so, so soft to a flaw. I like how these are a little bit harder in a good way. And the lip gloss formula, I really like it. I don't think it's my favorite lip gloss formulation in the world. But like I said, I think it would be fun to pick up a color, like a set of a color that you enjoy that you saw from today's video. I will have all the links to shop down below. I still love this lip. It's so pretty. All right, you guys, there we have it. That was my little swatch session with the new Natasha Denona I Need a Rose lip collection. Let me know your thoughts down below. What was your favorite color? Peony, Daphne, or Calla? I'd love to hear it. And I will see you guys in the next one whenever that will be. Goodbye, guys. Have a good one.